Omar, please share your. You can also tell us a little bit about yourself if you want.
Okay, that's awesome. Yeah, I'll do that. Hi everybody. My name is Raneem. This is my first. I'm not nervous, but this I am. This is my first time doing something like this, and if I stutter, I'm sorry.
Let's give our Woo! Round of
applause. I just wanted to, this is a poem, and it's not titled. I didn't feel the need to title it. Silently, I disrupt my memory so that what's left of the burnt nerve end would not matter. I have destroyed my central nervous system. It convulses at the outside, and I must attempt to control the inside, and that's where I fail, not it. The aftertaste of the underarm of Orion captured, leaving me without a drop of the stolen elixir. Comparable to dry wine subtly washing my speech is fine, accompanied with pleasant subtleties. There the sudden realization lies, stating the awful difference between bottomless obsession and sacred union. Shut your eyes or blink slowly as the tragedy befalls, as if that will empty it of its desire for devastation. Tragedy cannot go against its nature. It must fulfill its destiny of destruction, and your eyes cannot become darker as they shut. Only dilation of wisdom at the pupil. Denounce your role as one, look for a lover instead. Treat the defense as if it were romantic. Romantic love blesses the feeble, and they cannot cope with just the roses. An insatiable need for more attacks, and that in itself has no end, but a bitter cycle. How satisfying is the unconditional love, for it breaks the structure and knows no need for self-satisfaction. I've seen tragic lovers cry in grief corners, with only self-serving attachment harnessing these tears. I must hold back my soft laughter. Void of chauvinism, only light-hearted watching the purest fool, and I reminisce as if those were the golden days, an untouched cradle and virgin mind. Naives on a path of a journey I ventured on, and how ironic are these one-sided reflections until humans on the other side decide to rest on the easy boulder, smell the fresh-cut basil and mint of time, and softly breathe in that new now smell. Staring into the cosmic mirror and golden rules, and in felt-tip trip, softly afraid of the unknown void caressing the cheek of perfectly balanced nothing. So worried to forfeit the ruins of their empty central nervous system. Then they will remember gratitude that accompanied the dance of eternal love, a gift with no sender, only one that shines through a purebred pile of light. I give this to you and ask for nothing in return, to a solitude investigating the autoimmunity of the central nervous system. Even if my brain's exterior walls peel, and my agency compels, I've no need to stop it. The mind has disciplined river-like flow, but I spoke to my ancestors and desperately accused broken clocks to be regretful of their own waste of time. But I cannot speak, I am a damaged soliloquy. Simultaneous thought and touch a memory burned at the end of the film reel. The conscious wheel seashells, traps and releases me in its meditation. While we exist in a realm without pain, only perception of this emotional in cognitive dissonance between us, there is just a conscious thread of peace we have no pressure to attain. For I am the observer watching my conflicts rage, and the inner madness ensues while I delegate on whether or not I should interrupt you or continue listening to the beautiful harmonies within the vibration of your voice as you meditate on existential conditioning. And all I can think about is locking myself into the chambers of your angelic sounding existence and fragmenting until I am angelic nobody, but a passenger in your death cab, looking for the nearest exit to understand you better and to lose myself further in you. There is healing and refreshment from the dry lesion in my peripheral system. But I must equilibrate and die before you touch the imbalanced article, leaning against my chest, seeking you to understand my truth, and in return I will not owe you anything but feeling your trickling down honesty. I've stumbled into you as if ravens collected at my feet, and I understood they were kraken before I read it in the book I bought from the bookstore you love going to. We'll probably never read the same books I read for different reasons, and all that's left to address with another human being honest and undressed. I ask you, taking one last swig, drinking the likes of the cure to corruption with all the fixings, how damaged is your central nervous system, and who measures the quality to fix it?